Yeah, Will got a little men's health magazine here, man. New year, New Year's resolutions, man. You know, trying to get right, you know?
Yes.
Now, check this out. Guy here lost 285 pounds. Can you believe that?
No.
That is bananas. I wonder what it's like to be that guy. Oh, wait a minute. It's him.
Yeah, that's me.
Food and sports, two of the things I love the most. From the football fields at Wake Forest, straight to your kitchen. The best, the tastiest of restaurants. The biggest, the brightest of guests. Charlotte, North Carolina is my home. This is Wes Got Range. Wes Got Range, episode 11. It's the new year, baby. We're back. Outside of the Cowfish Grill in South Charlotte, this place, let me tell you, fusion spot, burgers, sushi, all types of good stuff we're going to show you in here. They got burgers that have sushi on top of it. They got sushi that's got burger stuff in it. It's going to be crazy. I got my man Vinson Smith, men's health alum, Kannapolis, North Carolina, finest, lost over 285 pounds. He's going to tell you how you can get right for the new year. But first, as always, we're going to go in here and heat it up. Back in the kitchen at the Cowfish Grill, I'm in here with my man Courtney, the chef, back here. And today we're going to make the Deliverance Roll. We're going to show it step by step. Courtney, what's going on? The floor is all yours. Let's show them how it's done, baby. All
right, first we start off with fresh pork, pulled pork it is.
Okay, I love that.
Yeah.
Love that.
I know, me too. Put it on the grill, let it get warm. We grab this. We always do
soy paper.
It is our rice machine. Yeah. Instead of like us spreading it or whatever, it spreads it for us. So all we gotta do is just put it on there.
That's high tech right there. Yeah, that's high cotton right there, Will.
Just spread this out if you want to be able to put it close so it'll close. Because if you don't close it, everything falls apart.
Wow. That's good stuff right there.
Yeah. Real high tech, right? And then I commence to rolling. And then we just wrap her up.
And the potato spaghetti. It looks like potato spaghetti right there.
That's exactly what I think it should be, right? Drop it right in there. Cooks for 3 minutes. Get the garnish.
Put the bird's nest. That's a bird nest?
Yeah, that's that. Barbecue sauce.
Never go wrong with that. So that's definitely a mix of Carolina and Asia right there. You got the barbecue, and you got the coleslaw in there, but it's sushi.
Garnish in the middle, and drizzle this on top of it, and sesame seeds. And that is your deliverance right there.
And deliverance, and I'm about to deliver it straight to my mouth right here. Let's do it. Smoky flavor from the barbecue. Coleslaw complements it perfectly. I'm gonna enjoy this. I'll see y'all in a little bit. At the Cowfish Grill, and you know what it is. It's time to eat. Look at all this delicious food that we got here. My man, Vinson Smith, Kannapolis, North Carolina's finest. Men's Health alum here with me. And we got my man, Chris, the general manager. He's gonna tell us what all this delicious food that we got down here on the table. Let us know, Chris.
Heck yeah, first up, we got the Wooshi Buffalooshi right up front here. This is one of our Burgushi sushi rolls, so it's got some chipotle bison on the inside there.
Name for the Queen City legend.
That's right, that's right.
Baby.
We got thin sliced jalapenos on top, some red onions, a little diced tomato. Okay. You got feta cheese on the inside there, chipotle aioli on the bottom.
All right.
Up top, you got your jalapeno popper showstopper.
Yes.
Five different kinds of jalapenos there. You got a jalapeno citrus aioli, jalapeno cream cheese, fried jalapenos, jalapeno bacon, and fresh jalapenos as well.
That's a lot of jalapenos. Yeah, that's a hell of a lot of stuff right there.
We got our Texas longhorn on the side here, sharp cheddar, half pound beef patty there. Onion strings, we got some jalapeno bacon on that as well with some barbecue sauce on top. One of our best selling burgers. We got a side of Parmesan truffle fries there. Diced bacon on the top, truffle oil, truffle cheese, and our thin sliced house fries. We got lobster crab spring rolls in the back. We got fresh lump crab in those, as well as fresh lobster. We got a Cajun marmalade and a cilantro pesto on the bottom there. One of our best selling appetizers, so you guys enjoy.
All right, we're definitely gonna do that. All right, so as we said, it's a new year, New Year's resolutions. Everybody wants to lose weight. Everybody wants to eat right. But we got the expert right here, Charlotte, North Carolina. HardBody Fitness is the gym. So let's just get right to it, man. When did the weight gain begin And at what point did you hit your breaking point where you said, okay, I gotta make a change?
The weight gain really began after the loss of my father.
Okay.
Lost him at the age of 16, my first week of my senior year in high school. So just going through the stages of becoming a man, it was really difficult not having my own personal Superman there.
Yeah.
So a lot of the weight loss really did stem from emotional eating that was out of control. The breaking point was when I really decided I wanted something more, a little bit more than an American dream. I wanted to have a wife, kids, a house, but I had a drive above that to keep the weight off, because it was one thing to get it off, but to actually keep the weight off and keep track of my weight management, that's been the practice in this 10-year span.
So day one, you said, okay, today is the day.
Mm-hmm.
What was that like? What did you do?
Day one, I probably ate a cinnamon roll and then went walking. But it was the next day after that where I really made my mind up on nutrition, what I was gonna do, whether I was gonna eat right or work out X amount of days. But I really started off walking from stop sign to stop sign in my neighborhood.
So what advice do you have for that person out there that is very heavy, that's looking for some type of start to begin that process? What would you tell them?
I would tell them, first of all, make your mind up. Either you're gonna do it or you're not, bottom line. And then also, you do want to seek help. So going to a regular gym, talking to a personal trainer, a fitness coach, expert such as myself would always help as well too. The biggest thing is really making up your mind that this is what I want to do, this is the path I want to go down, because it is it's a journey. No matter if it's 10 pounds or 100 pounds you want to lose, it's a mental mindset you have to be in to reach those results and to make it long lasting.
All right, now the weight comes off, you decide, hey, I want to be a personal trainer. When did that obsession come in where you said, hey, I want to do this for a living, I want to help others so they can feel how I feel now?
It really helped when I saw what really helped me cope with my weight journey, with my weight loss. And helping other people was a key thing for me. Seeing other people be successful in their weight loss transformations, it gave me the motivation to keep going as well too, because motivation can be hit and miss sometimes. You know, you can read all the Les Miles books you want and listen to ET and all that kind of stuff, but once again, if it's not ingrained in you, if it's not in your heart, if it's not something you think about on an everyday basis,
yeah,
it's not gonna work.
Now, starting to blow up, my man. Men's Health came and found you.
Yes.
All the way from Kannapolis, North Carolina, man, to the pages of Men's Health magazine. What did that mean? How did they find you?
How they found me, actually it was a year process. I had sent my story to them a while back. I hadn't even reached my goal weight yet of 225, so I hadn't even lost the weight, but I knew that was my goal, that's what I wanted to do. And lo and behold, they called me up late fall of 2016, and we were able to get the article out in December.
So we're gonna get to the carnage as we like to do. All right, let's see what we got. That's pretty good, man. Shout out to Flair. Woo! Look at the carnage. I mean, we just destroyed it right now. We did have some help. It wasn't just all me and Vince. Okay?
Like we always do, though. This is a typical thing.
This is a typical thing.
We do this.
We eat good. But hey, Wes Got Range, episode 11. We're back for the new year. Cowfish Grill, thank you so much. The food was wonderful. My favorites, I mean, how can you pick one? Because I like everything. I'm not even a lobster guy. I love that. I'm not even a cucumber guy. I love that. But the burger with the jalapenos and probably the Deliverance Roll were my two favorites. Vince, what about you?
My favorite, definitely the one right here with the bison roll. Right here, the Ric Flair. Woo!
Yeah.
My
yeah.
favorite right there.
Woo!
That's it.
Kiss stealing, wheeling, dealing. All right, well, tell them where they can find you, man. Tell them where they can find the best personal trainer, the only guy in Charlotte in Men's Health Magazine. Where can they find you?
You can find me in the University area, Charlotte, North Carolina, 216B, Stetson Drive.
All right, well, we're going to get out of here. But first, before we go, a little fortune cookie. Let's see what it says. Ooh, a secret admirer will soon send you a sign of affection. I like that. I like that. That's a nice one. What you got?
I got you'll find the beauty in ordinary things. Do not lose this ability.
Okay.
Oh, that's
all right, man.
I love
okay.
it.
We out of here. Once again, Wes Got Range, episode 11, Cowfish Grill. We'll see you next time. And as always, remember to eat it up.